Hey everybody, it's Momentary Flux. Welcome back to Sniper Elite 4 Shock Trooper Lorino Dockyard. Let's go. Need to run around and collect all the missions.
Red Fox calling Mother Hen. Red Fox calling Mother Hen.
Receiving you, Red Fox. Footage recovered from crashed observation plane shows multiple quantities of weapons being transferred to Lorino Dockyard. Find that armory. Out.
Red Fox out.
Good work on the partisans, Carl. OSS is mighty pleased.
And what with that? And Sicily?
Heard Operation Husky went pretty smoothly for you guys. Also heard Eisenhower has bigger plans. A mainland invasion.
Reich always has bigger plans, Carl. The point is that we've poked the hornet's nest. Things are stirring.
What things? This from your informant?
Dorfman? Nah, not this time. This is straight from our boys in aerial reconnaissance. There's a dockyard down the coast from here. The Germans are moving something.
Any idea what that something might be?
There's a lot of security, so whatever it is, it's gonna be darn valuable.
Which is where I come in, huh?
Got it in one, my friend. We need specifics. What it is, where it's moving.
And then what? Sounds like the Germans have got themselves a big operation.
Husky means we've got some bombers in the area. Now, once you do what you gotta, well, why don't you just give them flyboys a nod?
Something on your mind?
A man called La Terza, the harbor master.
Friend of yours?
A more venal, corrupt individual you could not hope to meet, except, of course, for that bastard, Boom.
Not a friend, then.
He's a traitor. Many of our people is sent to their deaths. Someone should make an example of him.
Is that so? Does the Angel know how bad it is?
She's our leader. She has other concerns. Without her, we are nothing.
I get the feeling she doubts herself.
She stepped in when Boehm's people snatched their father. He was an extraordinary man.
He casts a long shadow, I understand.
She's a worthy successor to her father. If only she knew that.
So Boehm's people took him.
No one ever saw a body.
That's gotta be hard on her.
It's not just that, Carl. OSS knew her father had been taken. But he wasn't classified, a strategic asset. So they did nothing to help him. Nothing.
Fearsome looking blade.
It was my father's.
Was?
Boehm's people took him in the dead of night. There's been no word. Nothing. Ever since.
I'm sorry.
There is a quotation from a poet. A mighty flame follows a tiny spark. My father was the spark. That's why they followed him.
The partisans? I didn't realize.
He was my father, and their leader.
It's a tough act to follow.
Yes, it is. But unless I find a body, I won't stop hoping. Hope is what carries us through. Feeling good about your little victory at the viaduct?
Did as you asked.
Thank you for that, Lieutenant. But the partisans are hanging by a thread. We need ammo, fuel, medicine. Madre Madonna, we need a medicine.
Typhus?
It's sweeping Allagra. Some of our people are already showing signs of infection. We know the Nessies are transporting vaccines via the dockyard. If you could find out where it is...
I'll see what I can do.
Okay, that's the last thing. I'm gonna gather up the supplies here and head on into the mission. Okay, so this mission starts out with a lone trooper there.
This place is crawling with guards. Better keep to the shadows if I'm gonna get the information I need.
If you kind of just crawl around to the side here, you can get a, you can sneak up on him, get a knife kill on him. That way, it won't alert the guy that's down below. There's another campfire down there. So down below, like I said, there's one more guy off to the right.
Think I've grabbed all I can.
There is a minefield. There's a truck that comes along here. If you can take this out, you will kill three or four guys. So I've alerted them. That's okay. I figured I would. Okay, I'm still using my suppressed ammo. I meant to change my loadout. I was gonna not have any, but I decided to just continue on with it like this. It's basically just extra bullets. I don't even care if it's suppressed. Oh, got a guy right here. Hello. I need to heal up. What I really need to do is I just need to get past this first little area here, get some of these guys cleared out, and then I can, once I have my beachhead established, I can start just working and pulling and bringing them out. I'm going to start to the left, and then I'm going to work my way to the right. One thing you might notice is that... I have switched rifles. I'm using the Mosin Nagant instead of the Gewehr 43. One of the reasons why is I find that this is this level has a lot more longer shots and a lot more Jaeger troops. So the extra power from the Mosin Nagant is a lot, makes it a lot easier to get infantry kills if you need to. It also has a better zoom. It has 6x zoom instead of 4x. And it has the, I believe, the highest muzzle velocity of any of the rifles. Which means that there's less bullet drop. Less effect by the wind. Take care of this guy here. That being said, I'm not used to it yet, not completely. This is the first time I've used it in this mission. I used it briefly in one of my other playthroughs at the beginning. But it doesn't have any of the upgrades or anything like that. It's straight stock. Okay, I think that's all the beginning guys there. There's going to be some more, I'm sure, running down from either the left or the right, or both. Yeah, I hear the music swelling.
Nothing else.
Alright, there we go. I'm still debating whether I should leave the default range adjustment at 0 or at 100 meters with the Gewehr 43, which also has a pretty good muzzle velocity. It's one of the highest out of all the rifles. I left it at 100, so I'm thinking I'll probably leave this at 100, but anything less than 50 meters with this is like, you kind of need to set it to 0 just because it's it aims true pretty well. Okay, I don't see anybody else over there. I think there might have been one soldier creeping around. Give him a second to show his head. Might as well do some looting. I can loot and keep an eye out.
That's all.
Still don't see him. I thought I heard him over here, but maybe I didn't. Oh yeah, I do. I hear him.
Lots of lights on in there.
Anyway, I think I might stick with this rifle from here on out. I do like the increased power, the 2-shot kills instead of the 3-shot kills, and it's especially important on the Jaeger troops. I think once I get my aim figured out on this rifle, it's gonna
like
be a little better.
Been helping themselves to goodies from the dockyard.
That extra zoom is pretty useful. We'll see how it goes when I get some of the longer shots. This rifle should actually be really good for long shots, with the good zoom and the high muzzle velocity. It should be pretty good. Anyway, the fire rate. I miss the semi-automatic, but I think I will be able to survive. I just have to be a little more careful with my aim.
Guess I grabbed everything useful.
And hopefully it'll help with my ammo situation, because I think it was last in the viaduct I actually ran out of ammo at one point, like completely out of all three guns. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in here into this warehouse, or a train yard, or whatever this thing is, and lure out all of the soldiers that are in here, and then there's the officer up to the left through this door. Hello. I'm also using, I think it's the Army P-38. Or not the P-38, the M-1939, I think, or 1938. Just to mix it up. I think the pistols are all pretty much the same. I'm putting a trap there just in case I need to retreat or if somebody runs around the corner. And then I'll throw a few rocks in there to sort of draw their attention. And we'll just pick them off as they come in. Oh, here we go now. He's gonna need a straw for his next meal. Okay, come on, buddy. Well, he took off to the left. Hopefully he'll come back up through the middle. If not, he'll be trying to... he'll be showing up at the edge of the tunnel here. Suppose I can reload. Here we go. Got a couple of them coming up. Actually, a little bit hard to see over there. It's kind of foggy. I don't want to get too out in the open. So let's switch to the SMG. The MKB-42 is what I'm using. The same as before. I still think it's my favorite of the SMGs. And he just used up my my S-mine.
Damn it, almost out of ammo.
I was kind of hoping to save that. I could pick it back up and keep it, but it did its job. Okay, I'm not sure how many more there are. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think there were six. Let's throw another rock out there. If there's anybody out there, maybe they'll go look for the rock.
Nearly out of bullets.
Sometimes guys kind of stack up on the left here. So I'm going to throw one over there. See if anybody chases it. I can. I like to throw rocks at the explosives or the gas tanks, that kind of stuff, so that if they do walk over there, I can just shoot the tank and get a guaranteed kill on them. And sometimes you get multiple guys coming to look for those, look for the sounds, and it's a great way to sort of save ammo. You can use pistol ammo to just set off the oil tanks or the gas tanks or the little containers or whatever it is. It makes it kind of easy to get some good kills on the guys. You do have to tend to wait a little bit for them to hear the sound and then make their way over to it. But they eventually do. And you can just keep
nothing
throwing
else
rocks.
To find.
You can just keep throwing rocks until they do. If you hear them around, anyway. Okay, so up in that that room there, underneath the big eagle, is the officer. He's got a code for the safe. So he'll eventually show his head there, and I can, is that him? Nope. Once he shows his head, I can just take a shot at him. He also walks out onto the balcony there. Oh, there he is now.
Hello.
Okay, 43 meters.
Something nice for him.
Low. Okay, so I think there's it's possible that I could be drawing some more guys from back there, but usually no. I think I probably have them all.
I think I've grabbed all I can.
They're back. I see one now. So I'm not sure if he knows where I am. I'm going to try to lure him into the open. The rock. Actually, there's a barrel there. If I throw a rock at the barrel, maybe he'll go over there and investigate. He looks curious. Go have a look, my friend. And another, his buddy ran out from behind there. I didn't even
know
he was there.
Running low on ammo.
So that's what I'm talking about. You can, if you lure him. Oh, I got one coming up behind me here. He's also going to look. Liking this Moss and Nagant, the aim is very true on it. It's it's a little bit different than the other one. I will admit that I tried a previous playthrough before I starting this one here, and I was trying the I think it's called the Ross Mark III, and it has a really
where the shipment is going.
It has a really low muzzle velocity, and wow, talk about bullet bends. Like even over 100 meters.
That's what I was looking for. The document says the shipments have been sent to Alagra, and they've been having problems with the Mafia stealing from the dockyard. Useful to know.
Anyway, I thought the Ross Mark III would be a pretty good gun, but I failed to take into account the muzzle velocity on it because I saw the damage was good. I saw the fire rate was a little better than average, etc., etc.
That's all.
But when I started using it in practice, that thing is... Man, bullets were flying all over. They were taking these snaky paths through the air and stuff. It was crazy. So anyway, I was really having problems, and I was kind of unable to hit things. So I went back to the Gewehr 43 for a little bit, and then I eventually decided for this run, I'm going to try the Mosin Nagant. And so far, this thing is pretty great. I'm really liking it. All right, so what I need to do here is I need to put a trap, and I want to set it outside a little bit because sometimes they chuck grenades at me as I try to lure them back. And if they throw a grenade, I don't want them to destroy my trap. I'm going to trap both sides, so that way this one will be protected if they try to sneak around the corner. So we'll just put an S-mine there. What the idea here is is that there's a radio man up there. Now, if you don't kill the radio man and he discovers that you're out here, what'll happen is he'll call in support troops. Okay, got him. Good. It's urgent that you kill that guy, otherwise he brings in trucks of the Jaeger troops, and it just makes your life that much tougher. So I'm unsure at this point if they know I'm here. It's really hard to tell sometimes with the suppressed ammo if they know you're there or not. Generally, if you're far enough away, they won't notice. But if you're fairly close, even with suppressed ammo, they tend to know you're there. I don't hear the music going, but that doesn't mean that they're not coming to look for me. There's one now. See if I can squeeze one into the very edge there. Yeah, I know for sure now that there's a bunch of them on the way. I think there's about 6 or 7 guys that run around in that courtyard down there. Okay, I'm gonna try to get these guys before they set off my my trap. I'd like to conserve my traps and save them. I'd like to be able to reclaim those traps if at all possible, because I can use them elsewhere. I've really taken a shine to using the traps to sort of protect my positions. A lot of times you kind of have to retreat back a little bit in authentic mode, because it's hard to tell where the guys are at times. And there just went my other S-mine, so it's possible that they could be coming in from that side now. Well, I still have the trip mine over there. Maybe I can get them to come around. Oh, I see a little head poking up behind the crate there. Maybe a little grenade. Maybe that would be the right thing to do here. Let's see, is anything going to pop around the corner? I also have those explosive canisters there in case I need to get them that way. I still see that guy's head over there. I'm not going to be able to get a shot on him. Let's throw a grenade over there. And here they come. And we'll just use our SMG. Finish them off. Alright, that probably is all of them.
No more to find here.
Let's get looted up. Oop, hail.
Need more bullets.
Well, it's sort of fortunate that I moved over here. I thought my trip mine would have got that guy. I wonder if I set it off with my grenade or something. Well, I'm keeping an eye out here as I loot. And I'm kind of making my way out there now into the open. So, just as a note, there's a sniper.
Guess I grabbed everything useful.
On one of the dock cranes. and he is about 150 meters out of the doors here to the right. I need to take him out. I can't let those snipers have free reign. They will absolutely tear you up if you don't get them out before they get you. This is going to be my first big test with the Moss and Nagant, because I'm not sure sort of how it handles. I didn't take it to the shooting range beforehand. I figured I would just see how this went, and if I, you know, if I had
this'll
a terrible outing,
useful.
I would just restart. But so far it's going good, and there he is. I'm going to pump it up to 200 meters and aim low. It looks like wind is pretty much dead on. That was too high. That was too high also. I think I'm still shooting too high. It's hard to tell. I got a hit there. I lowered the range adjustment to 100, so I'm aiming higher. Yeah, that's interesting, because he was like 150 meters and the 200, the rise on that was quite a lot. So when I lowered it back to 100, I was almost actually able to aim dead on, which I find kind of interesting, because you know, he was 150 meters. I should have had to aim high with the Gewehr 43. I would have had to add another like a head height to the aim to make that work. But with this, it was pretty much it was almost dead on.
Can't
really
find anything.
I'm really
else.
Liking it. It's working pretty well. Okay, there's some rifle ammo, but I think I got some full up. Now down in the courtyard here, down by that. I guess I should have done that. Down by this. What is that? The Tendler Pharma.
No doubt about it.
This
Those
type,
are the typhus vaccines.
The typhus vaccines.
Let the partisans know where they are.
And then I'm up on top of here is one of the mission objects, which is one of the spotlights, one of their air defenses, or harbor defenses, I think.
One down.
And then way over there, there's a anti-aircraft gun, I believe it is, that needs to be taken out. And it's surrounded by several troops. So we got those guys marked, and I'm gonna try to see if I can get one or two of them from up here. And that was very close. Yeah, I'm getting my aim dialed in a little better now. I'm figuring this gun out. Okay, this guy's behind the mast of that boat. I'm trying to pick his little head off there, but maybe I should scoot over. Or maybe he'll scoot over for me. Here we go. See one of those moss boats in the back there too. Okay, there we go. Now I think that's all of them I can see at the moment. Making sure nobody's running up on me. I do see one more down there. I can switch down to the 100 meter range. Just over his right shoulder. Well, hit him in the shin. I'll take it. So that's it's kind of nice that, you know, two hits, you get that infantry kill. Okay. So we got the spotlight up here, and now that area is, I wouldn't call it clear, but it's definitely better. It'll be a lot easier to make our way over there. Now, there's one guy, I don't know if I was just for kicks to see if I see the guy way out there at the lighthouse, 420 meters. What kind of, and then we got over a bar of wind. I'm not going to waste my ammo. That's pretty impossible. That looks kind of far to drop there. I think I could drop on this crate. And let's just run across over here to this water tank or oil tank or whatever that is. See if we can see anybody else around. I'll come back and destroy all these tanks and stuff. Oh, hello. He's only 119 meters. Should be able to just aim to the left a bit. And there's another one. Surprisingly, did not hear me. I've twitched at the last second there. Let's blow up the truck instead. And hopefully, if anybody else is over there, the noise from the truck exploding is going to bring them out. I have a good position here. Should be able to handle them without too much problem. Maybe I'll get on top of this tank now, or at least walk this way and see if I can see anybody else. Yeah, so anyway, there's a bunch of tanks and APCs below. They never get activated. Nobody gets in them and starts driving them around. There are a couple of tanks that show up during this level, and the way that the tanks get shown up is when you destroy the anti-aircraft guns. I hear one. Hold on, I'll finish that thought in a minute after we find out who's making the noise here. Some gas cans, maybe I can lure him over to the gas cans. There he is. It might take too long to get him to come over there, so maybe I'll just take a crack. Oh, there's another one. Okay, perfect. And let's just finish that other guy off. I don't know who he's signaling to. He's signaling to a crate. He's like, come here, crate. Alright, so let's see if we can see it. Give it one moment here to see if anyone else creeps out of the woodwork. I think there's another. Well, I wonder if I could take that boat out. That would be awesome. How far is it? 200 yards. It's going to get a little bit closer. I can take a couple shots at it, I suppose. Okay, it's 150 meters. Let's go back to 100 meters. Just behind it. Yes! So yeah, there's some depth charges on the back of that moss that if you hit them, it takes out the whole boat. The first time I tried one of those, I just tried to take out the gunner first, and then I was trying to take out the boat pilot. But I figured out that if you just shoot those depth charges, the entire thing gets taken out. All right, let's slide on down here, and let's make our way over there to the anti-aircraft gun. Hey everybody, it's me from the future. I have to end this episode here. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.
Nothing else.